Hello and welcome. In this video, I'll be showing Wave 35. Now on Wave 35, there will be a Jet to the northeast, a level 400 Mage to the southeast, a level 200 Ranger to the southwest, and a level 300 Melee to the northwest. Now for this wave, I've come up with three possible methods you can do it. The first method will lure three of the four monsters so that only one monster is attacking you. This method will use the least bruise, but some people find it hard to understand. Now at the start of the wave, you want to pray mage and stand on the west side of the middle rock. When you see the wave 35 sign, activate your invulnerability crystal. A level 300 melee will spawn to the northwest, let it hit you once, then run 1 north and 2 east. Now keep an eye on the level 400 to the southeast. Once you see him stop moving, like here, then move 1 east, 1 west. This will push Jad east, so he's not within melee distance of you. Then from here, you can mage Jad without him meleeing you. Once you've killed Jad, mage the level 300 melee to the west, then range the level 400 mage to the southeast, and finish up the wave by meleeing the level 200 ranger. The second method is more simple, but you'll be taking more damage. At the start of the wave, you want to stand on the north face of the middle rock on the east side. You want to pray range, wear high melee defense gear, and have your staff out. You want to kill the level 300 first while still prayer switching for Jad. At the start of the wave, Jad will be able to get an attack on you. You want to pray according to whatever attack style Jad is using. Once you have the right prayer, look to the west and attack the level 300 melee. Then look back at Jad and pray accordingly to whatever combat style Jad is using. Once you have killed the level 300 melee, you can now mage Jad. Once you have defeated Jad, you can range the level 400 mage. Once the mage is dead, you can melee the level 200 ranger to complete the wave. Now for the third and most simple method. Now this method is simple because you will just be praying mage, you don't have to prayer switch for Jad until later. But you won't be protected from the attacks of the level 200 ranger and the 300 melee. At the start of the wave, you want to stand on the west side of the middle rock, then run all the way west and touch the lava. Now a level 300 melee will spawn to the north, a 400 mage will spawn to the southeast, but then you'll be praying mage, and a level 200 ranger to the southwest. You want to have mage out and mage the level 300 melee to the northwest. Once you've killed the 300 melee, you want to stick to the west wall where the lava is and run south to melee the level 200 ranger. You want to be sure that you're sticking to the west wall because if you're even one step east, Jad will be able to attack you. Once you have killed the level 200 ranger, you want to run back north. Line up your camera so that you can see that you're directly west of the middle rock. Then run east so that you're touching the west side of the middle rock. From here, you can choose to range the 400 mage, or you can move northeast so that you're only fighting Jad. Now, if you brought range, I would suggest ranging the level 400 mage, but since I only brought hybrid setup, I have to move one step northeast so that I'm only fighting Jad. And that sums it up for my guide on Wave 35. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.